Hello and welcome back to Joy's Creative Finger. I've built a farmhouse this weekend and I really love the way that it's come together. Originally, this isn't what I intended to build, but I was playing around again with the lower level, multi-level roofing idea that I've been, able to test out over the last couple of weeks. And I like what I've seen at this point, so I thought I'd share with you. And there are two porches, but the center porch is actually really huge. You can't see it. It's obviously further in where this arched sort of entrance is, and I can't wait to show you that. But the other porches have table and chair sets in them. I use the Moroccan windows on this build. A bit of greenery here and there. However, even though it's called a farmhouse, it doesn't necessarily mean that there is a ton of animals everywhere. You're only allowed two pets in Sims Free Play. So just imagine that the entire vast land around belongs to farmer Alex, who lives here. So that's one way to look at it. However, it's the style of a farmhouse and it's really traditional on the inside. Now, I always now try to pay attention to the rear of properties when I build, try to give them a little bit of character, don't neglect it, and just make it look half as nice. And yeah, we're coming back around to the front. The A-frame roof works better when trying these wraparound porches. Although I did try the gabled, it worked, but I preferred the A-frame on this one. And sadly, we've only got two colors. You've got the blue and you've got the black, and the black is quite heavy. So I'm stuck with the blue. This is Alex, the farmer who lives here with his wife and his twin girls. Here is a close-up of the porched area with the table and chair set. I think it's from the romantic event or so. I think it is anyway. But another thing that was really nice is I placed these plants against this creeping vine fence, and it just looks like it's part of one item. I think it's really nice. Now we're gonna go straight into this arched area. I love the way it matches up with the square opening here. But this is my favorite porch of all time. I just love it. It's large, you can sit out here, placed a few green bits and bobs around, and you can see these beautiful windows from the last Christmas event. I think it was the Christmas Carol. And these windows have little planter boxes attached to them, another swing set inside of this porched area, and this bike. In my mind, it looks like a real bike that someone just gets on and then rides off. So you've got this lovely little space that's shaded before you come into the main family house. I love that space. So you come into this lovely space, it's slightly bare, wooden floors. It is a traditional farmhouse and it's really spacious on the inside. It's not a tight, packed home. That's the stairway going upstairs and a door leading to the back of the house, okay? The back of the property. And then you've got a bathroom or cloakroom on the side here. There are four bedrooms in this house and the one downstairs would find this really useful. You've got a shower, a sink and a toilet unit. The toilet units from the update that we've just been in, I think it's nice with the exposed pipe. And then you have this large archway that leads into the living room area. Now, you know I typically build modern style homes, but when I do build these traditional homes, I'm telling you, I'm in love with it. It's so pretty. I love this paneled area here with the sheep lap wood, the bookshelves, the fireplace. The chairs are fantastic in this space. The patterned rug. It's got fresh colors and it doesn't look grimy or anything like an old rundown house, but it's just really pretty and I love the colors everywhere. This is the harp from the Christmas Carol event, and then you've got this beautiful arched window. And at first I put chairs in there and it didn't make sense, it didn't look right, so I placed this chest of drawers, and you can see in the window those set of chairs and the table outside. And don't worry, the live build will reveal how everything pulls in together, okay? There's a door here that leads into what should be a bedroom, but I've converted it into an art studio for Janine, who is the wife of Farmer Dan. And this is her space. It's got lots of knickknacks, little tubs of different sorts of paints and gels and glues. She's got a painting chair on the side, and then she's got that lovely architect type table here where you can work at, and then boxes full of scraps and an easel and so on. I just love the way the room is sort of like a dump in a way. But yeah, that room could use this bathroom. So if you've got a large, Sim family, you want to move into this property, you can add that as a room. So we'll work our way across the big hall to the dining and kitchen area. Again, this is another favorite space of mine in this build. I just love the way the colors came together, love the fresh bowls, love the large table, and I've always said that this has become my favorite table now in the game, with these beautiful pumpkins on there, the candles, the color, and of course they've got that beautiful window again on this side facing the porch. There are some cabinets on the side there. This beautiful art piece is part of a pack that is in your game currently right now. There is also other single ones as well. You've got a apron shelf, and then this is Janine, who is busy cooking and cleaning and organizing the fridge or shelf area. That's where I would stick a fridge, but I love this kitchen. I can't tell you, I never planned it this way, and so when it came together this way, it gave me a lot of joy. And I thought it would be nice to put this oven here, but that could be a fridge if they would give us fridges that match up with the counters. I think that would be very nice, I really do. So this is where she is, going through the inventory of her frozen room, I would call it that. And I just love the way the colors are distributed in this space. So that's everything downstairs. I will give you an overview. In the live build, always, I'm going to put in the doors. I'm going to take my time. I think the last one I did was a little bit fast. I'll try and not be so fast. And it's simple, there's no glitches. I'm really pleased about that. And now we're going to go upstairs. So now we're up to this level, and you'll see that there is a balcony out here from that door. And as he comes upstairs, he'll just come right through. And you know what's interesting, as I said before, just assume that this is a really large piece of land that belongs to him. So the house is there, but he's got acres and acres, which is what farmhouses would look like. So we'll head back into the house, and what you'll see is a much more lived in space, a lot more casual than downstairs. There's their records situated in that corner. You've got this lovely lived in couch here, a chest of drawers, a television. Again, there's just a fireplace downstairs. So this is the floor where they really spend time. This door leads into the room that now belongs to Paige Towers, who was known as Pearl Rivers when she was a baby and she was abandoned by her mother. She's now at school. She's having such a difficult time adjusting because she was homeschooled for 11 years. So much has changed. She's now in a class with real people, no longer online. She's now in a new home with people she doesn't know. And she's no longer in touch with her parents who raised her all her life. They've been remanded in custody and there will be a hearing. Her real mother, Lily Rivers, has been informed that she's been found, and we're going to find out how this all comes to a head in the end. Paige Towers has had her whole world come crumbling around her in one day, and sometimes in class she would have a complete breakdown, head towards the door, start screaming that she wants to see her mum, she wants to see her dad. And the teacher would have to come over, calm her down, advise her to, snap out of it and get on with the class and realize that she's here in a secure place, a safe place. And sometimes the kids would even giggle. So this has been really difficult for Paige at this time. She doesn't even know what her real name is. So it's something that will settle with time and is really difficult for foster parents such as Farmer Alex and his wife Janine, who are doing absolutely everything to keep her comfortable in this beautiful room. This morning the farmer's wife had prepared a lovely meal, pancakes, strawberries, hot chocolate and so on, and she wouldn't have the meal, she wouldn't have it. They've got her clothes, bags, shoes, everything that she could possibly want, but she's completely miserable. She wants her mum. She wants her dad. She wants to go back to the private island. And this is how lives can get destabilized, even when you're trying to fix it. This door here leads into the closet. It's like an earring cupboard, where you hang your clothes or dry your clothes. And it's also like a storage cupboard too, so you could keep your little bits and bobs in here, like your vacuum cleaner and so on. Further down the hall, we've got a family bathroom. It's very large, and I was meant to put a washing machine in here. I've completely forgotten. Anyway, it's a very large bathroom, as you can see. I've used all these items from this current update. I love the fact that these pipes are exposed and things look sort of old. You know, you've got the laundry baskets, there's supposed to be a washing machine there, and that's the tub. So the girls share this room. And we're going to head over to the twin girls' bedroom. So that's the door right there. And they've got a really lovely bedroom. They're a little bit younger than Paige Towers. And they are in a completely different school. So that doesn't help either. Paige is really isolated right now. But this is the room I put together for the twin girls belonging to the farmer. I think it's quite lovely. And it's wonderful that we don't have to glitch to place lights, these fairy lights and these wall lights above the bed. You know, the bed is against the wall and then there's the fairy lights against it. It's fantastic. This is the closet for them, so you can walk in and do what you need to. They've got a study area on the side, a lovely window revealing the view, the grounds, fairy lights again on the wall. I think it's fantastic that this sort of placement is possible. I'm really pleased about that. They've got a little area to play dress up, the pair of them, and I think it's quite cute. And that's the entire bedroom for the twin girls. And then you work your way back through this living space to the master bedroom. It's a really large space and I really like it. You've got the big bed, you've got the chest of drawers, some ointments and towels, and an art piece on the wall. You come in through that door. They also have a nice vanity table here for his wife and himself. And then they've got their little snug closet in the space. If you take a little peek, you can see that there's closets in there. And then you've got the window, okay, with a couple of chairs from, I think, the very first Sim Chase event, okay. And these lights on the wall change a brighter green when they light up. But yeah, that's the space for them. Then there's the door that leads into their family, the master bathroom. Very large, again, very spacious. A tub, baskets for their laundry. And in this little nook here, they've got their own toilet unit tucked away. And the toilet roll holder is on the outside of it. So that's everything for this house. I promised you there's a life build. Yes, there is. So stay tuned for that. I always say that if you choose to recreate this in your town, that's great. Says you love it so much. I will also upload it to the architect tab. I do that now. And I can do that because I no longer glitch. I haven't since the year began. Or even from just the ending of last year. So I will upload it too. And I will recreate it here for you now. If you choose to recreate it, however, and then upload it to any social media platform, be it Facebook, YouTube, Instagram, and so on, that's beautiful too. But don't forget to use the hashtag JoyceCreativeFinger when doing that, and I'll be grateful. I hope you have an amazing weekend. I hope you're getting on well with the, I think it's the diner event. I hope you win it all. And I'll see you again soon in the next video. Take care. Bye.